We are going to discuss the software architecture and how it is different from the design. So we'll be focus on the architecture. Just remember, knowing concepts like abstraction, inheritance, and polymorphism do not make you a good object-oriented designer. A design guru thinks about how to create flexible designs that are maintainable and that can cope with change. So two keywords here is maintainable and then the change amenability. Right? So the software architecture, what is software architecture? We'll see the difference between the architecture and design. Why? Because these two words are often, they're confused. And why architecture is so important to us? Like MVC, MVP, MVVM, three-tier. So what is software architecture? When you talk about what is the software, what it is going to be, how you are going to make the software, how it is you are going to make, the combination or the intersection of these two questions will give you the answer of the architecture. IEEE says architecture is defined by the recommended practices as the fundamental organization of a system, embodiment in its component and their relationship to each other and the environment, and the principles governing its design and evolution. One more is architecture captures system structure in terms of component and how they interact. So the baseline is how components, we are talking about the components, what is the structure of the components and how they interact with one another. So the primary focus on aspect is, these aspects are performance, reliability, scalability, testability, maintainability, and various other attributes which can be key both structurally and behaviorally of a software system. So software architecture and software design. First you make the architecture and the embodiment of this architecture, inside you make a design, and then you following these architecture and the design issues, you code. So all of architecture is design, but not all design is architecture. Software architecture, non-functional requirements, architecture deal with it. Functional requirement, design deal with it. So this is a tabular difference representation of architecture and design. Architecture addresses the fundamental properties. Design, the detailed properties. Architecture defines the guidelines. And design communicates with the developer. The architecture is telling us the cross-cutting concerns, while design is telling us the details of it. Architecture is high impact. Design is all about the individual components. The architecture communicates with business stakeholders, and design uses the, it uses the guidelines. The architecture, it manages the uncertainty, and design tries to avoid the uncertainty. The architecture is a conceptual integrity, and design tells us the completeness. We are aware of the cycle, the SDLC. So, the architecture plays a vital role in establishing the structure of the system early in the development lifecycle. First, you conceptualize the software, then you perform preliminary requirement analysis. After this, you design the architecture. So, architecture sets system structure. Then, you develop a version, deliver a version, elicit customer feedback, incorporate the customer feedback in an iterative lifecycle model. This is where the architecture is important. What about the architecture terminology? We can have a multi-tier architecture. So in software engineering, this multi-tier architecture, which is also known as the N-tier architecture, say is a client-server architecture in which you have a presentation, then application processing, or you can call it as a business logic representation. So presentation, business logic, or application processing, and then you have data management. The multi-tier architecture is a client-server architecture in which functions are physically separated. There is a separation. And the most widespread use of multi-tier architecture is a three-tier architecture. Three-tier. This is your presentation layer. Presentation of object A1, A2, B2, C2. Then the business layer. So these interact with the business object. These with business object B and this with C. Here you have the business layer where your business logic resides. The presentation is only for viewing or showing purpose. And it interacts with the business layer. And then you have this data access layer where you can have databases, etc. So you're not directly dealing with the database. There is a abstraction layer, which is the business layer, where your businesses or business layer is, or business algorithms and techniques are there. So what is the use and advantage? First, if you want to change certain things, you don't have to go to presentation layer or data access. You can change your programming or your application or business logic here only. If you want to access the database or change the database structure, you don't have to even touch these two layers. You can directly deal with this layer. This is an abstracted multi-tier architecture. What about the model view controller architecture, MVC? We have heard this a lot. You know, Java people, they are aware of this. So here the controller can send commands to the model to update the model state. Controller is sending command to the model to update the model state. For example, say editing a document. It can also send commands to its associated view to change the view presentation of the model just by scrolling through a document. So editing, scrolling, controller. What this model does then? It notifies its associated view and controller where there has been a change in its state. This notification allows the view to produce an updated output and the controllers to change the available set of commands. So in certain cases, MVC implementation might instead be passive, so the other components must poll the model for updates other than being notified. What about a view? The view requests information from the model that it uses to generate an output representation to the user. So we have MVC, model, view, this is view, model, view, controller. So we have one to many relationship with controller and view. So there can be various view, number of views, and controller is one. This is the MVC architecture pattern. As I said, the view, this is responsible for rendering the model, that is user interaction. And say you are rendering list box control, so it can facilitate you the selection. What about the model? First we'll go to the controller. So controller is responsible for responding to the user request. Say it is instructing the model to respond to the user input. For example, if you want to render the list box control, it handles the list box selection event and sends the information to the model. What model is doing here? Model is responsible for storing and entering data. Say the maintenance of the state, a notification of observers of change in the state. This is MVC architecture. What is model view presenter? MVP is a user interface architecture pattern engineered to facilitate the automated unit testing and to improve the separation of concerns in presentation logic. The model, the view, the presenter. So model is an interface defining the data to be displayed or otherwise acted upon in the user interface. The view is a passive interface that displays data, that is the model, and routes user command to the presenter to act upon that data. The presenter acts upon the model and the view, these two. It retrieves data from repositories, that is the model, and formats it for display in the view. There is one-to-one relationship between the presenter and the view. So how it is happening? Presenter is the key. Model, it controls data flow. And the view, presenter provides data, view, fire the events on input. We also have model view adapter. Model view adapter. So the model view adapter, or say mediating controller, and this E is an architectural pattern and multi-tier architecture which is used in software engineering. So in complex computer application that presents large amount of data to users, developers often wish to separate the data and the user interface. Again, for complex computer applications that present large amount of data to the user, so developers often wish to separate this data from the user interface. So it concerns so that changes to the user interface will not affect the data handling, and that the data can be reorganized without changing the user interface. Then we have model view model. So model is the domain model which or the data access layer that represent that country. The view refers to all the elements displayed by the GUI such as button, labels and other controls. The view model, which is the model of the view, this one, it is an abstraction of the view that also serves as mediating between the view and the model, these two, which is the target of the view data binding. So it could be seen as a specialized aspect of what we saw in the MVC pattern that acts as a converter that changes the model information to view information and passes the command from the view into the model. So controller, some references for this MVVM also include the controller layer to illustrate the view model. It is a specialized functional set in parallel with the controller while others do not. The binder, the use of declarative data binding and command bind technology, this is an implicit part of the pattern and the relationship many views can use one view model. This is we are talking about. We have view model and between we have view model. So view user interface events goes to view model. The update goes to the model. The read is done by view model, and the model change events is taken by view model, and the view model data is shown to the view. So this was about the architecture and the difference between the design and architecture. We will be taking the design shortly. Thank you so much.